Jonathan Paula presents Game Time.
Greetings, Hotshot, and welcome to episode 24 of my Grand Theft Auto 5 Let's Play on the PlayStation 3. When we last left off, I had just bought myself an apartment on GTA Online and was tricking out all of my vehicles, which means now it's time to actually use them in some races, deathmatches, and gang attacks. So let's continue now with GTA Online. Let's continue our free roam fun here and rob a bank or something, right? Or maybe I should just find some people and fuck them up. I don't want to be that guy, though. I don't want to be the guy that initiates a fight. I have no issue battling people, battling other humans, and fighting back. That's a nice car. I wish I bought that one. But what I do have an issue with is just starting fights unprovoked. That seems unfair to me. And I don't want to be that guy. But what I can do is drive near people and wait for them to combat me. I'm not going to throw the first punch, but I'll stand there and shout names at them. And as soon as they start the fight, then I'll be like, "Hey, you started this, chief." I think this guy just went at the customs here with his bike. Yeah, he did. I lost him. It's all right. It's all right. It's okay. All right, this car handles decently. I'm not going to say it's great. It's not. But it's okay. Certainly faster. Oh, gang area. Let's check out the gang area. This big red circle on our map here indicates that I have approached a gang area. Or, in other words, an area with a gang in it. Look around for crates containing loot. I don't have a lot of weapons, but... Boom! Gang attack has begun.
Are you kidding?
Are you kidding? Oh my god! Get the gringo! Which is a great movie with Mel Gibson, by the way. Oh my god, where is he? I have to go back to my day shift at Taco Bell! Alright, that's just racist. Although, statistically speaking, if they worked in Los Angeles, they live in Los Angeles, there's a good chance they might actually work in Taco Bell. Like, let's be honest, they have a lot of Taco Bells down there. People love their Mexican food, am I right? First Taco Bell I ever went to was in SoCal, even though there's one like 3 minutes from me. How did that happen? I don't know.
We have a man down over here! Maybe it's because somebody got shot in the fucking face! Annie up, bitch, move! It's Wubba Gooba and the green team!
Who am I getting shot at? And from what direction? Nope, sorry. Can't help you there. Gang attacks are nice because they're not humans and there's a whole bunch of them. But I don't have to feel bad about killing them, you know? You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Dun 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 dun. These used to be a good source of income for me, but now it feels like... it's a waste of time almost. It's good experience, good reputation, and it's a fun little activity, I guess would be a good word to say. It's fun. I'm having fun right now. Who's shooting at me? Whoa! Oh, there he is. Hello. I don't think he's dead. That guy's dead. That guy's dead. Let's switch weapon to the SMG. Oh, don't go back up, back up, back up, up! You're gonna fucking die, you dummy! Shit, I died. I got wasted! What's nice, at least, is that I just immediately respawned without a hospital bill, so that... that's a plus. Zoom the camera in a little bit here. Am I still an SMG? I am. Okay. Suck on it. Suck on my bullet. Now, this mentioned something about crates and getting, like, money. Where's that at? Where's my money crate at? Where's my money crate at? Take out the enemies. How many enemies are in this gang? I wish they spawned to begin with, because like I feel like I've cleared an area, and it's like, nope, you haven't, because here's more of them. Let's go back upstairs, see if they, see if they're still around. $25? What is this? 22?
load of shit. You're a jerk. You're a jerk. I'm going to take your money. I'm going to take your $13.
Oh, man. I'm wasting time.
That's right. That's right. Take out the enemies. Do they just keep coming? Is that what's happening here? Is this like an infinite respawn thing unless I take them all out quick enough? Maybe that's it. Maybe I have to take them out within 30 seconds. And if I lollygag between kills, maybe more of them spawn? I don't think so. That wasn't my experience with the other three or four gang attacks I've done prior to this. But it certainly seems like this is a never-ending supply of bad dudes. And definitely more so... No! No, you're gonna die! You stupid shit, I killed on the ladder again. It was a mistake switching to the vest. Should have left the full suit on. Oh, there he is. I can see him. Right there. Right there. Come on. Oh, I got him. I don't know how, but they found me. Run for it, Marty! What do we got in here? Anything? You're upstairs. Take out the remaining enemies. Roger that. 10-4. Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. You get a trophy if you complete an entire gang attack by yourself without getting killed. That is a trophy for the PlayStation 3. And one I've already unlocked, thankfully. This one is not one I would have been able to do. It seems a little harder than most. What? There he is. You're dead. It's all over. Gang attack passed. Yeah! 30 kills! I'm definitely positive I did a gang attack. The first one I did only had 15 guys. Maybe each time you play a gang attack, the next one... as more people, or is it dependent on the location? I don't know. Where are the crates of money? Is this a crate? Is this a money crate? Can I go inside? Like, what qualifies as a crate? That, I mean, I would call that a crate, but it's more of a storage unit. Storage Wars, next on TLC. What do they find in the crate? Coming up after the break? Nothing. They didn't find anything of value. $28. You shitting me right now? I know there's some $500 bills all around here. Why can't I find some? Fuck it, I'll do it live. Let's climb to the top of wherever I'm at and explore the space. Maybe I'll take out my sniper rifle and kill some human players. Oops! Did I do that? You were killed by Steve Urkel. Or possibly his evil alter nemesis, Stefan. You ever watch Family Matters? Or I should say Family Matters after season 2 when Urkel became a frequent recurring character. You know that when they began the show, Urkel was not part of the main cast. He was actually like the next door neighbor and only had like a few appearances. But then he tested so well with audiences they made him a huge part of the cast. And later in the show, there were the entire plot threads revolving around him and his time travel exploits. That's when the show just got weird. It began as like a show about an urban black family in the suburbs of Chicago. A spinoff of The Jeffersons, if I recall correctly, because I believe Carl Winslow was like the, I don't know, like the doorman or the police officer in one of the episodes of The Jeffersons or some stupid shit. So I got a parachute. Now I can keep going up and do some cliff diving here. Scumbag! But yeah, in the early episodes of Family Matters, it was like a serious, like sitcom about like, you know, a black family in the suburbs of Chicago. And then they totally changed the format to this black nerd who has a cloning machine and can fucking time travel. Who's this jackass? Hey, what do you want? I'm gonna fucking punch you. I'm gonna kick you. I'm gonna punch you some more. I'm gonna kick you in the balls. Ball kick. Ball kick. Curb stomp. Teeth smash. Good. Fuck you. Just trying to enjoy my view up here and maybe do some parachuting. But no, you had to be a total thunder cunt. So you got killed. Seriously though, look it up on Wikipedia. I guarantee you there's a paragraph saying, Family Matters underwent an extreme tonal shift between seasons 3 and 7 when it went from a black comedy sitcom about growing up in Chicago to one fucking kid's obsession with time travel and cloning himself for some reason. Weird, weird show.
But I liked the time travel stuff. I'm not gonna lie. When I was a kid, I loved the time travel. I thought that was super cool. Can I jump to that building? I guarantee I can't, and I'm gonna fuck up and die. So let's jump off this way, which is where I left my car. Parachute! Oh, that was close. What the f- Come on! Come on! What? I did not hit those logs all that. I go back inside this lumber yard here and retrieve my bench. Big old bench. Also, what's interesting too is another thing you will read on a Family Matters Wikipedia page is when the show began, you know, the cop from Die Hard, Reginald, what's his name? Reg Reginald Johnson, whatever, Vaginal. He has a weird name. It definitely has a V in it, right? Weird name. Great. I piece of shit. I meant to do that. Definitely meant to do that. They had a daughter, right? They had like a really young, like 6-year-old daughter. But as the show went on, like that character just fucking disappeared. Wait, whoa. Someone just shoot me? Or is my car just so damaged to just pop the tire out of nowhere? That's some bullshit. I should go back to my apartment and get the other car I own. Cause I own two of them now. I wanted to explore this, and that was a mistake. I shouldn't have done that. Learn my lesson. Don't explore. Don't explore, kids. Stay inside all day. And watch Family Matters, only on TBS. I think when it originally aired, Family Matters might have been on ABC, though. Don't quote me on that. I'm not a very smart person. Is there, like, a store over here I can fucking rob? I want to rob a store. Oh, yeah. Oh, there's definitely a store over here. Definitely a store I can rob. Right here. There's the store. Okay. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to hit select. And we're going to go to inventory. And we're going to put a mask on. We're going to put the white hockey mask on. We're going to get out of the car. Depress select. Just get out of the way. Hit. Okay, here we go. I'm going to go into this store and I'm going to rob it. And I'm going to take all the money and I'm going to run away and deselect the mask. Hello there. And that way I won't have a wanted level as high anymore. All right. Put him up, please. Bitch!
I'm emptying it.
What? Oh, shit! Oh. You saw what happened, right? You definitely saw what happened there. Oh, I screwed that up. I pulled a gun on him that didn't have any bullets, and when I tried to shoot at the wall behind him, which would scare him and make him empty the register quicker, my gun clicked. He realized I had no bullets and immediately defended himself. That's unfortunate, you know? Alright, so I got 2 stars. I immediately dropped to 2 stars by changing my mask. So that's good. And now, if I can get out of this mess, I can, hopefully... I'll be fine. I don't know where I was going with that sentence, but I'll be fine. I was hiding in my apartment, but I don't think I'll need to. Got in this alleyway right here. Oh, they're coming. Get inside. I think there's a stunt jump or something up here? I don't think so. Just a regular garage here. They're not going to find me up here, though, so that's good. My 2 stars will go away. It was a shitty bank rob, but, you know, I did my best. Oh, there we go. Got away with it. Got a little bit more EXPs. And now I can hit this ramp here. I don't think it's a unique stunt jump, but I can hit it just the same so I can get off the roof. Oh, no! Just like I drew it up. Speed bump. Slow down. There's a human player around the corner. Let's see what he's up to. Human player, hello, how are you? He's just minding his own business. I could totally run him over and be a dickhead, but again, that's not how I play. That's not me, man. That's not me. See a parachute. Ooh, another gang attack. I don't want to do that, though. I think I've already done it, actually. Oh, there's the parachute mission. Okay, right here. Thought I was going to have to go up top for it. Construction bail. Let's do it. Oh, I'm not wearing my glasses. I can't see. That's right, I'll figure it out. I'm only parachuting. Why would I need to see where I'm going? All right, let's host the session here. Construction bail. When you were standing on top of a skyscraper in reconstruction with no elevator, there's really only one way down. A technical descent from 880 feet with several tight turns. Gotta turn off the radio. Time of day, current, weather, blah, 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 blah. Auto invite and play. Let's do it. There's no time to screw around. I just need to get right into it, alright? I have a clumsy rating for my stealth. Probably should work on that. And I probably could use some more time in a plane. Otherwise, feel pretty good. I like that Wonderbrad 82 is in a crew called Crew. The Crew Crew. The Cutting Crew. Just dying in your arms tonight. It must have been something you said. I can do a really convincing Scott Stapp when I need to. With arms wide open. It's just like, it's also the guy from Nickelback, right? Sort of a bullet. I don't know how that song goes. I'm not a huge Nickelback fan, I'll be honest. I don't think anybody is. If you are, I feel sorry for you. That's unfortunate. Hey, let's go here. I'm hosting a fucking Let's Play. I don't got time to slap a chop hoe here. Hey, it's Caesar97126. We saw him get killed earlier. No, we didn't. We turned off the TV before we had a chance. Samax. He must be a Burn Notice fan. Chaser542-7904. What the fuck is with these people's obsessions with random strings of numbers? I swear to God, some people just use their phone number for their username. It annoys me. I'm not gonna lie. It totally annoys me that I'm one of the only persons I've ever seen on any online game use just a fucking their birth name. John Paula. Like, that's my username. That's my name in real life. That's my name here. I don't see anybody else who's just like Joe Smith. Nobody. I have seen, I think, in all of my travels on Call of Duty, on Grand Theft Auto, and playing hundreds of other online games, maybe one or two people that use first name, last name. And the people I know don't count because I associate myself with people who aren't 12. And I feel like a lot of these kids, like Jay the Reloaded, all caps, like what is that? What is that? Who are you trying to impress? STLD? What does that mean? You sexually transmit the Lyme disease? I don't know. I don't know what your clan name means. I think it's stupid and I don't like it. Bronx Kid Rob? Is his name actually Rob? Like, that's at least a step in the right direction if his name is actually Rob. But I think he could work on that. I think if he just called himself Rob, I would have slightly more respect for someone who has the maturity to not hide behind, one, an anonymous name, which I understand the need for anonymity online. I don't really, especially on the Grand Theft Auto. Like, oh, you got to track somebody down that you played against because you have their name? Like, how many fucking Robs are there in the Bronx? Guessing more than two. But secondly, I feel like it's just uncreative. Like XX Sam Killer 69, like, that's a stupid name. It's just dumb. Some of them are interesting, some of them are creative, but generally speaking, they're all really difficult to pronounce or read or spell, and they're dumb. Wonderbrad 82. That one's better because it has proper case. But generally speaking, I don't like any of the ones in here. The Rise of Tivod? I don't even know what that means. I hate Caesar's name. 97126, like, that's... I swear, is that his phone number? I don't know. I'm gonna put a $500 bet on myself. Winning toast is salute. I'm gonna hit ready to play. Take a look at the lobby here. We have a level 20, 36, and a 16, I think it was. I'm the 27. I gotta pay attention quicker. Better. Faster. Harder. Stronger. What? Parachute through the checkpoints. Hit the center for more points. I'm wearing a helmet? Pfft. Don't need that. Press square to dive, then press X to open the chute. Boom shakalaka! Oh, open! Open, Jesus Christ! I almost fucked that whole thing up. I hit X. I swear I hit it. I really did hit it. You go back and check the tape. You can hear it in the background. Don't matter, I'm still in first. Although I think that's because I am physically in first. I'm getting the points before they are. They might actually have more points when they get to this position, but in the meantime, I have more points. All right, this is gonna be a tight turn. You can do it, JP. All right, here we go. Coming in for a landing. Coming in hot. Oh, faceplant, -5, but landed on the target. That guy missed the target. That guy landed right on it. But how did he do with the checkpoints? Did he get more points than I did? 42 seconds, 7.05. 7.09. Finish first! Did my bet pay off? I didn't see the screen that said all bets were canceled. I might have won some money with that one. We'll find out right after this. And I got a new rank! That's the rank horn. Bet wins! 200, that's it? Oh, Jesus. Should have put like 4,000 grand on it. It turns out I did not rank up. What? Fuck you. I am ready to go, just waiting on you, Flava 83 and Gendy 81. Now, 83 and 81, do those numbers mean anything? Are they your birth year? Maybe, are you a 32-year-old guy playing this game? Possibly, this game is rated M for mature. But there's also the possibility that it means absolutely jack shit, and you just couldn't get the first 82 versions of that name. I remember when AOL first came out way the fuck back in like 1996 and I signed up for an account, my first username was MarioMan43. I wanted to use Mario Man, that was taken. I wanted to use MarioMan33, because 33 is my favorite number, but that was also taken. So I went with 43, because I don't know why, that was better than 333. I'm not entirely certain why I came to that conclusion. Rank up, motherfucker, you're a soldier now! Get in the game! Oh, man. I don't like this race. I hate it already. Right, music off, I have to concentrate, which is to say I have to host a Let's Play and race at the same time. I don't know that I should have used this custom vehicle. I feel like I might have messed up with this. I feel like the Banshee, maybe not. I like the Feltzer. I think it's called the Feltzer. Fletzer? Feltzer? What's that? Feltzer? Feltzer? Ferris? Bueller? 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 No? I don't know what it is either. Yeah, this is a shit car. It slides around at fishtails too much. $105,000 mistake, that's what they should call it. It's a little too long to put on the back bumper, though. Get your $105,000 mistake at your nearest Hyundai dealership. All right, I love the sound that the checkpoints make. Vroom. Vroom. It's a very rewarding sound. Well, that guy flipped out. That guy flipped out. This guy... Well, there's one and two right here, so I'm back in. I'm not out of the race yet. In fact, I'm very much in the race. Get the fuck out of my way, jackass. Glad my headset's not on, because that's not something I would actually say. I would be polite. I'd be like, excuse me, sir, I would like to take the lead. Do you mind if I take point for the remainder of the race until it finishes? Haha. And he'd be like, I do mind, in fact, you jackass. Ooh, whatever I did, I sent him off the road a little. Oh, Jesus Christ! Hold triangle. Respawn. Sometimes you just gotta know when to quit. That was one of those times. There was no way I was gonna be able to get back out of that ditch quicker than respawning. Again, I have no issue listening to the music, but I feel like if I listen to it when I'm trying to record, it's gonna create some content ID match problems with YouTube. It's gonna distract me a little bit. We can't have that now, can we? No, we can't. What place am I in? Third? There'd you say? Oh, all right. How many seconds back am I? 16? Shit on a shingle is a delicious thing I would not mind having for dinner tonight. You ever have that before? Shit on a shingle? Very delicious. Basically, it's like a stack of mashed potatoes, corn, and gravy on like a London broiled style like piece of meat. So it just looks like a just clumpy, like soupy food on top of like a piece of meat, like a piece of pork or it's not steak. I think it's beef. It's probably like a beef. It's very, very tasty. If you've never had shit on a shingle, look into it and see if you can make it or get your mom or your girlfriend or your wife to make it for you, because that is fucking delicious. I love that stuff. And it's easy to make, too. It's simple. Like, if I cooked, I could probably handle it. But I don't. My wife handles that department. I live in a very traditional household. You know, I bring home the money, she brings home all the food. It's a great arrangement. But she's a tremendous cook and I'm terrible at it. Oh no, car! Alright, so I'm in second place. You saw me pass that guy a second ago. There's not a lot of people in this race, so if this was like a 16 player race, I'd be like, alright, I just have to hope that players 2, 3, and 4 get tangled up and I can take the lead. Right now, my only hope is that Gendy81, the genderbender, up in first place, gets into a massive car wreck with an NPC, and I can maybe gain on it. But I'm just going to play smart. I'm going to play, I don't want to say conservative, but I don't want to take any undue and unnecessary chances here. I want to kind of stay safe and just make sure I don't lose second place. Because at this point, he's so far ahead, I don't know that the best racing in the world is going to get me back in first. I think using the Banshee was a mistake. I think my vehicle is just, like, statistically speaking, just slower than his. Like, there's no way I can beat his car unless he just stops and waits for me. I decided to use a custom car because if you race your custom cars in races, you can unlock more features. But honestly, I'm not sure I even like the Banshee enough to invest more time and money into it. Whereas in the sports category, there are plenty of other cars way faster than the Banshee. They're not cars I custom own, so I wouldn't have got additional, let's say, help in that department in terms of being able to upgrade new features. But I feel like I made a mistake. I feel like it might have been more important just to pick the fastest car in the group and just win the race, rather than picking my slower custom car to work on personal improvements. Because right now, it doesn't matter how well I raced this last lap. Like, I've only gained a second on him. And I don't want to say I've done a flawless lap, but it's certainly been a lot better than the first run. And I'm not, pedal to the metal right now, not really making any progress on that lead. He's going to cross the finish line any second now. He's 19.1 ahead of me. 19.1. And there's only like 3 or 4 checkpoints left. It's good to say he finished in first in about 3, 4, 2, 1. There we go. Finished first place. I counted up before I counted down because I wasn't really confident about my time. I was close, though. He was... He had a good lead. This other guy, though, where is this other guy? He's 32 seconds back. Wow. He totally fucked up. I'll take my second place. Distant second. But I will take it just the same. Thank you for participating. 6 minutes and 22 seconds, 370. Mark, 370. Wow. Holy shit. Wow. Even with second place, that race was worth the 6 minutes. Genderbender gets the lead. First place. Probably ranked up a lot of cash and RP. He certainly did. Unfortunately for now, that does it for this episode of Game Time, but stay tuned or click the playlist link below for the next installment of the Grand Theft Auto 5 Let's Play, where we continue our online mayhem with some deathmatch domination. As always, thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.